What do the numbers in this story and the leader of the Autobots have in common? They're both Prime!
Autobots, roll out!
Hey guys, welcome back to The Stemulous. I'm Steph Evs, and here's what happened this week in STEM. While there are four letters in the STEM acronym, I rarely find stories pertaining to the M part. So when I saw this story, I absolutely jumped all over it. So what is the latest math news I'm sure you're asking at this very moment? Well, it's recently been announced that a new largest known prime number has been discovered. For those of you that haven't covered this in math class, a prime number is a number that can only be divided by one in itself, such as 2, 7, or 11. This latest number, known as M77232917, is just a wee bit larger than the examples I named. It only has around 23,249,425 digits. That's a lot of significant figures, y'all. This number has the designator M in front of it because it's a special kind of prime number known as Mersenne prime, named for the French monk Marin Mersenne, who studied these prime numbers in the early 17th century. Mersenne prime numbers are numbers that can be expressed as 2 to the nth minus 1, where n is also a prime number. The number following the M in the number designator is the exponent n, so for M2, the number would be 2 squared minus 1, which is 3, the first Mersenne prime. In the case of the latest number, the exponent is huge, with the number itself reading 2 to the 77,232,917th power minus 1. According to a statement from the Great Internet Mersenne Prime Search, or GIMPS, a group that dedicates their time specifically to searching for these numbers, the number M77232917 is big enough to fill an entire shelf of books totaling 9,000 pages. In addition, if you wrote 5 digits of this number in an inch of space every second, it'd take you 54 days to finish, and when you're done, you'd be 73 miles from where you started. My hand is cramping just thinking about it. The first person to bring up Mersenne primes was Euclid of Alexandria, a Greek mathematician credited with being the father of geometry. While Euclid brought up these numbers in 350 BC, the guy that they're named after wouldn't study them until the early 1600s. Despite these numbers being studied in depth for over 350 years, this is only the 50th Mersenne prime to ever be discovered. So how does one find one of these numbers? It sounds like it would take a long time to multiply 2 by 2 by that many times and then subtract 1. Well, you would be correct, imaginary person that I'm asking the question for, which is why we have computers do it for us. GIMPS members collaborate using their computers to search specifically for these numbers. All you need is a reasonably modern PC with the free software installed. If you're lucky enough to find one, there's even a cash prize involved. Since their founding in 1996, GIMPS has discovered the last 16 Mersenne primes. For the latest discovery, it took 6 days of non-stop computing to prove primality, and then it was independently verified with 4 different programs running on 4 different hardware configurations. The lucky prime finder in this case was Jonathan Pace, a 51-year-old FedEx flight operations finance manager in Tennessee, who's one of the thousands of volunteers working with GIMPS. He's been with the organization for over 14 years. So why look for these numbers at all? What good are Mersenne primes? They're actually used as the basis for important cryptography algorithms, but don't hold your breath for more of these to pop up anytime soon. These numbers are getting progressively harder to find with a discovery rate of less than 1 per year. But if you want to learn more and potentially get in on the action, I will include a link to the GIMPS website in my sources down below. Happy number hunting, kids! So that brings us to our question of the day. Are you interested in getting in on the Mersenne prime hunt, or would you rather leave it to the pros? Let me know in the comments section down below. If you want to check out this story a little bit more in depth, I will include links to my sources down below, along with links to all of my social media and my Patreon page, so feel free to check that out in your free time. If you like this video and you want to see more STEM-related content just like this, feel free to give the video a big thumbs up and subscribe to the channel so you never miss any of my future videos. As always, if you find any really cool STEM-related news stories throughout the week, please feel free to send me a link on Twitter @TheStemulous using the hashtag Twistem, and they just might make it into a video. But with that, I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your week. Stay well, stay awesome, and I will see you next time.